Don, do you want to tell me where you were born and when you were born?
I was born in St. Louis, Missouri, July 1st, 1926.
Okay, and how old are you?
92.
Wow, you look great. You look great. And did you, where were your parents from?
My parents were U.S. citizens. It was their parents that had come from the old country.
Where did they
come? My father came from Switzerland. My mother must have come from Germany.
Did you know your grandparents?
I knew my mother's grandparents, but I didn't know my father's grandparents.
Okay.
Although he had a wild experience. He got over here and got into Nebraska. His wife died. So he sent a letter back and said, send me another one.
Wow. And did they? Did
yeah.
they send another?
Oh. And she, I knew.
Okay.
Yeah. She lived in Trenton, Illinois, which is 30 miles from St. Louis.
St. Louis. Okay. And did your grandparents, did you hear many stories from Europe that they told? No?
No.
Didn't talk much about that?
Didn't talk at all about it.
Okay. Okay. And did your parents meet in St. Louis? That's where they were from?
Well, no. My father was from Highland, Illinois. My mother was from Trenton, Illinois. They're neighbors.
Okay.
About 20 miles east of the Mississippi.
Okay. And so you grew up in St. Louis, and are you from a big family or a small family?
No. Just my brother and I.
Okay.
He was 5 years older than me.
Okay. And what was life like in St. Louis then? Pretty nice?
I never lived in a house until after I was married.
Really?
Really. Lived in an apartment building.
Okay.
Six family apartment building. Had a black man who was the janitor. You know, I got to be great buddies. When he wanted to play the horses, he'd borrow $2 from me.
To gamble?
Always paid it back.
Okay.
And in the 25 years we lived there, we never had a Christmas without it. Christmas, we'd get up, pound on the radiator, and he'd come up and have Christmas with
us. Well, that's a nice memory to have.
And he was able to attend our wedding at our church. But he couldn't go to the reception.
Because things were different back then,
yeah,
right?
Right, right. Very much so.
Were there a lot of kids in the apartment building?
Yeah, there was a boy, a girl across the hall, but I think the rest of them were adults.
Okay. What did your dad do?
My dad was a pharmacist.
Okay.
He had 8 brothers, and they were all pharmacists.
Wow.
Yeah.
Were you a pharmacist?
No.
No? Okay.
My brother was a pharmacist. Oh. I was an engineer.
Okay.
I like to do things with my hands.
Okay.
And I followed the janitor around. Every time he was fixing stuff, I was his gopher.
So you learned how to fix things. Wow, that's good. Good practical advice.
Yeah,
yes.
Very much so.
And then did you, I think you're a veteran, right?
Right.
Okay. And where did you serve?
I was in the fizzle in Japan. I spent, I was taken in the Army in 44 spring.
Oh, okay.
Went to Fort Ryle, Kansas. That's where General Custer was trained.
Oh, wow. That was right when the war was ending, right?
Yeah. And and then went over to Leyte, Philippines.
Philippines, okay.
Right. Took 30 days.
To get there?
To get there, because we went down to New Guinea unescorted, and then back up to the Philippines, and then 10 days to get to Japan.
Wow.
And we pulled into Yokohama Harbor the day the Missouri was signing armistice.
The end of the war, yes.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. So then, did you have to stay there a while still?
I was there in a year.
Okay. Okay. So did you see a lot of the devastation in Okinawa?
No, not Okinawa. Tokyo.
Tokyo, okay.
It wasn't that kind of devastation.
Okay.
And there were the Japanese had a military academy about 10 miles outside of Tokyo, and we were billeted there classrooms.
Okay, and you stayed there a year. Was that the Army you were in then?
No, I was in the cavalry.
The cavalry? Oh, okay.
I was the last increment to travel to train on horseback.
Wow, that's really interesting.
But I was a radio operator. 11 weeks training. I only had two with horses.
Wow.
Those other guys had 11 weeks with horses.
Wow. Were you pretty good?
The bad thing about it, it was in the winter in Kansas, and it snowed.
Oh.
We were living in pup tents.
Oh.
And the only nice thing about having a horse is they have hay. And we go put that down in the pup tent and help.
To make your bed?
Help make the bed a little warmer.
Were you pretty good with horses?
I have never done what they did on those horses.
Okay.
We went downhills and uphills.
And when you were in Japan, what did you do? What was your job over there?
Radio operator.
Radio operator,
the
okay.
Division of 1st Cavalry.
Okay. And you stayed there a year and came back to St. Louis? Or where did you come back to?
Yeah, came back to St. Louis. I had a half a year college before I left. And so I was needing to finish the college. GI Bill helped a lot there.
Where'd you go to school?
Washington University.
Okay.
It's an older school, but a very prominent one, especially for engineering.
Engineering, yeah. And did you, were you married?
No, that's where the peculiar part starts. After the war, my wife and I had always gone to the same church, a Presbyterian church. She was a couple of years older than I was. So we went to the same grade school, but didn't really know one another that well. And so, after the war, we had what they call Christian Endeavor, which was church-sponsored get-togethers and fun and having parties. And so she and I were only two that weren't married.
Oh, okay.
So we went together for about 7 years while I went to school and finally got a job. And then we were married 65 years.
That's really good. That's a long time.
Yeah, huh? She just passed away last November.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Yeah. Oh, okay. So, a long marriage. Do you have any children?
We tried to have children and weren't successful, so we adopted.
Okay.
We adopted two. We adopted a boy and a girl. Girl was 4 weeks old, and the boy was 6 weeks old. It was from an orphanage.
Okay.
That friend of ours from our church had adopted a son. And so when we went to interview, the lady said, would you take two? Which kind of floored us, because we had been turned down by United Way.
Uh-huh.
Because we had miscarriage. So they met. My daughter-in-law lived in Houston, and my son went to Trinity, and she went to Trinity, and that's where they met.
Okay.
So they're both ministers.
Really? Oh, yeah. Nice.
Okay. She had been the prime minister at Westlake Hills Presbyterian Church.
Oh, right here. Okay.
Until they got a new minister, I think, a couple of days ago.
Okay.
She had run the place for 2 or 3 years. And my son worked for the Presbyterian Seminary in Austin.
So they're both here in town then?
Yeah.
That's nice.
Well, that's the only reason we're here.
Yes, yes.
In 2015, we were on vacation. We generally went down to Gulf Shores, Alabama for about 15 or 20 years, the month of March. And we got there on a Sunday, and on Monday she had a stroke.
Oh, okay.
We never went home.
Hmm. So that's why you came to live in Austin?
Right.
Okay.
We had moved while she was still rehabbing to Dallas because our son and daughter-in-law were in Dallas. Then they moved to Austin, and I said, no, we don't want to move. And then I started having some physical problems, gave up the car and the computer, and said, okay, we'll move.
And what kind of work did you do?
I was an assistant controller of a company called Carter Carburetor.
In St. Louis?
In St. Louis.
Okay.
I worked 30 years for
them. Oh, very good.
You know what a carburetor is?
It's in a car. But you could tell me more about it.
It used to be the means of supplying gasoline to the engine.
Okay.
Now it's all different with this new...
catalytic converter?
Yeah.
Yes.
All this stuff.
Yeah, yes.
So...
okay.
Yeah, I've been retired since 87.
You like retirement?
I did before I started having difficulty. I'm a woodworker. I've been at all my life. I guess I get some of it from my janitor buddy.
You learned from him?
I had a complete shop.
Oh, a wood shop?
Wood shop, yeah.
Okay.
Table saw, band saw, planer, joiner, and a wall of area of our home. And I used to go to craft fairs.
Okay.
Make all kinds of little stuff.
Nice. Yeah, it's a good hobby.
Yeah, really.
And how about your wife? Was she a homemaker, a housewife, or did she have a career outside of the home?
Yeah, since she was a little older than me, she was running a real estate office, a small office, I think 2 or 3 people, until we adopted the kids. She worked 4 or 5 years.
And how about your dad? You said, what did your dad do?
My dad was a pharmacist.
Pharmacist.
But and he died when he was 72. It was back in, I think, 1960. So he was gone a long time, but my mom lived to be 101.
Did she really?
Yeah.
Was she in St. Louis all that time?
Yeah.
Wow, some good genes, huh?
She was in a nursing home, yeah.
And how about your brother? Where was he?
My brother was a pharmacist, and I don't know what, he had some health difficulties, and he died sometime in the 90s.
Well, what would you say, growing up, what did you do, and were you involved in some high school activities? Or?
I don't know that I was involved that much in high school activities, in church.
Church activities,
yeah.
Okay. Right. And how about your daughter?
My daughter lives in Rolla, Missouri. She's got 3 boys. Because of the distance, we are not in contact with her that much.
Okay.
Although she's 2 years older than our son.
Okay.
But everything I'm working through is through our son, mainly because he's here.
Yeah, that's why you're here, right? Okay. How about growing up? What kind of parents did you have? Were they
strict?
Strict parents.
Very much so.
Were they pretty involved in church activities also?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It seemed like I grew up in the church.
Well, that's not a bad thing, I guess, right?
We had a church. I don't really know how old it was, but it, when I was a kid, dirt floors. So in the 30s, the men got together and said, let's cement it. So I helped them with cement.
Oh, so you've always been busy with activities like that, building.
And the one thing nice, we used to play ping pong all the time with this group. And the weirdest thing in the world is my wife. She always wore high heels.
While she was playing ping pong.
Yeah. She was living in high heels.
That's not an easy thing to do. Wow.
So she was a good ping pong player, too.
Good. Yeah. Now, how about when you were in the Philippines? Was that your first time out of the United States?
It was the first time I'd ever been more than 50 miles from St. Louis.
Wow, that's a big step, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so. And then being, I pulled a good one on cavalry. Fort Raleigh, Kansas is about 100 miles east of Kansas City.
Okay.
Okay, you could get a 3-day pass to Kansas City. And I lived in a suburb of St. Louis called Florissant. I told them that's where I was going, Florissant, just the other side of Kansas City. I didn't have much time at home because of the distance.
Right.
That was another couple of 100 miles.
Okay.
But we made it all right. Nobody got hurt.
And then when you went to Japan from the Philippines, right?
Yeah.
And how long, you were a year in Japan?
Yeah.
Year in Japan.
Yeah, I got out in the fall of 46.
And you were you one of the last people, to, the Army forces, to leave Japan at that time?
No. The thing that's so peculiar, the 1st Cavalry Signal Troop, that's the group that does division communication, never had a casualty.
Wow.
All doing the war.
Wow.
So when we hit Japan, they all went home.
Wow, that's a good thing, yeah.
Well, yeah, except us 90-day wonders, we're supposed to run the place.
So there was no one there to run it.
Yeah, right. It's a little difficult.
Oh.
But we made a...
Did you keep in touch with anybody's from the cavalry?
I did that for a few years, but there were some guys from California. But
everybody's all spread out.
Okay.
And how about who would you say was your biggest influence in your life?
Well, I guess being with my wife, we had a fantastic relationship.
Oh, that's really good to hear.
And she was financially oriented, so that we were able to talk money and be comfortable with it.
That's very important.
Yeah, apart from her business dealings. And we discuss everything.
Well, that's good.
Great.
Good.
Yeah. As I say, we never had an automobile or a home. A house.
A house, yeah, till you got married.
We had a home. We got married in 52-4.
That must have been exciting to be in a house then.
$13,000.
Wow.
2-bedroom, 1-bath. And some of my grandkids are saying those houses now are worth $300,000.
Wow.
And I can't comprehend.
I know. That's amazing, isn't it?
Just unbelievable.
How about growing up? Did your parents have any good stories to tell you about their growing up years?
The only thing growing up with my father, St. Louis has a pretty good sized zoo. This one guy that used to be on TV, Vera Heller, used to be in charge of the zoo. We never owned a car the 25 years that we lived in an apartment.
Did you take streetcars or buses or?
Okay. Streetcar.
Streetcar.
Every every day my dad had a time off, we used to go to the zoo.
That's a good memory to have,
yeah,
going to the zoo.
Very much so.
So was your dad the pharmacist in town, right where you lived?
Okay. Well, he owned the store until the Depression.
Oh.
And he went to work for his brother.
Okay.
The thing around Texas here, everybody's football conscious.
They are.
Well, in high school, we had a nice football field, but no football team.
You didn't?
We didn't. The school across the street from us practiced on our field. Uh-huh. And then when I went to Washington University, there are no scholarships for athletics. So
it's more an academic.
Yes.
So this is new to you, all this football, huh, in Texas?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Although every time, I'm a great Cardinal baseball fan, every time I look at a paper, try and find something out about the baseball.
Yeah, because we don't have any professional team here, so there's not that much baseball news. Yeah, that's right. We're in a college town now,
yeah.
So it's all about the college. Okay, how about anything else you want to tell me?
My wife and I have been to Europe once, but this is on a tour, and we went to Austria, one of the stops, Swarovski. You ever hear of that?
Yes.
Crystal?
The jewelry, yes, yes.
The tour guide was saying, we'll stop there. They've got seconds, that sort of thing.
Okay.
So we stopped. My wife's a great collector of turtles. I don't know why, but she does. So we bought a turtle. Picked it up, gave it to a clerk. That's the last we saw of it. Well, they wrapped it, you know, gave it back to us, and we weren't going to fiddle with it at all till we got home. When we got home, it was a rat.
Oh, no. Something got mixed up, huh?
Oh, yeah. Well, in my travels, we had a plant in Tennessee and used to go through Nashville, and there was a Swarovski place in Nashville, and I finally got her.
The turtle, oh, good. Good. Okay, Don, well, thanks so much for talking with me. It was a pleasure.
Enjoy it.